I think there's a very basic religious comment that you've heard, I've heard before, and that is that comment towards the end of Jesus' life where he gets crucified, and what he says is so profound, and he says, "Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing." Yeah. So the same thing with us. The divinity is willing to forgive us because we don't know what we're doing. Why we go to certain end, we don't know that. I don't even hang around with that. Because if I do and I dwell, I just go spiral down. The more and more memories come. So when something comes up, I catch myself and I get back to the process. I don't go over how come I went there. I don't know how come I went there.
Even sometimes if I say something stupid I shouldn't have said, I still clean afterwards once I catch it.
Yeah.
And even if I feel funny still, I ask myself, did you clean?
Yeah.
And then I can get my relief from the anger.
Yeah. Because what happens is we're so used to, the pattern is, I'm guilty. Bad, bad, bad. So let's say I make a mistake and I say in my mind I have some nasty comment I have about Will. So I go, oops, and then I begin the process of cleaning, and then I'll hear an override saying, you shouldn't have said that, I clean up that. I just keep cleaning with it, and then finally it just gets quiet. But I'm looking for any aftermath when I'm doing something, as opposed to say, how come I said that? Jesus, I shouldn't have said that. Too late, or you're stuck, you're wallowing, and you're just stuck in it. So I want, if I can hear it, and most of the time I can't hear it, that's why I'm always drinking soda. But if I hear myself, I shouldn't have said that. I get to the clean. Oh, why did I go back to the clean? I try not to stay engaged with these things. Yeah.
So there's no relief in the other way.
Yeah.
You can't get any relief.
And you can't help it. You're stuck. Once you go down there, the reason you went down there is because of memory replaying. But if you cancel that memory, you can't go there. But the memories are always, they're relentless. So the idea is just stay with the cleaning and not get stuck in how come, why? Why did she say that? I've been that route. It doesn't bring relief.
And even in that time when you do the cleaning, that other person seems like they kind of dropped it. But I don't know how did that. They're onto something else already.
Yeah.
Nobody's stuck anymore.
Yeah. And now, can you imagine? You could have been doing the cleaning, and now you get an experience. That person's stuck. You're not stuck. But you don't know that somewhere in Africa, a woman was given birth. But because of your cleaning, that birth was much easier. We don't even know that. That's how profound this is. Because when you cancel, let's say divinity cancels memory 442 in you, that memory gets canceled in everything. Every drop of water, the ocean, the dogs, everything gets canceled. And so you've done your part. Not to cancel it, that means everybody's stuck with it.
So if you snap in anger.
When people email me or call me, which I hardly take calls, just the email, as I'm watching it, so they're saying, I'm having this problem with this person, they're not having that problem with that person. What the problem is the data plane. So if that data plane is playing at me, so when I do this cleaning, I'm not doing it for anybody but myself. I'm looking at getting at the data. Now, once that data gets canceled in me, it gets canceled in everyone, including that person. This is why people who at Hawaii State Hospital had some problems don't have that kind of go home.
What does that mean? That always catches my mind, that data is in you. What does that mean?
That means that since we are... let me give you a story. There's a book that's written that shows at the physical level that all of us share the same DNA. They go back to four women, just four women out of Africa. So if you look at all humanity, they're able to take a DNA and trace that DNA all the way back until they come to these four women. That means we're all family. We all share the same information. That means the Ho'oponopono is saying, if we're all family and share the same data, then if I erase the data in me, I'm going to erase it in the rest of my family, including drops of water, the geese going by, because we're all family. That's what it's saying. That's the data is in everybody, in everything, even a situation. Yeah.